7A Baseball Power, so it should be a really, really, really fun and competitive contest tonight. So the lineups for the night, first for the visiting Newton County Tigers, coming in with a record 18-6. Cooper Johnson playing center field to lead off. Vance Richardson will be a shortstop in the two hole. Cooper Lewis will play right field and hit number three in the lineup. Hayden Amos will be your catcher, big cleanup. Collier Mangum will be in left field and hit fifth. Ethan Burton will be in the sixth hole and pitch. Camden Toms will hit seventh, play second base. Dalton Graham will hit eighth and play first. And Landry Talbert will be your third baseman and hit ninth. For the Knights, will be Jacob Wooten leading off, playing shortstop. Owen Shirley will get the catching duties, hitting the two hole. Cannon Graham will be your three hole hitter, playing second base. Lee Jenkins will be your cleanup man tonight and play first base. Carson Smith will be his designated hitter. Hunter Russell will play left field and hit sixth. Caden Peoples hits seventh, play center. Caden Boswell will get the nod on the mound and hit eighth. And Carter Horton will be your third baseman and hit ninth. Zayden Moore will be your right fielder. So Boswell's going to take the mound. Boswell comes in with 35.2 innings pitched. He's got a 6-1 record. Walked 15 guys, struck out 46. Leading the Knights in strikeouts this year is Caden Boswell. ERA is 1.570. Caden's going to throw strikes. Batting average against Caden's a measly 155. So he's kept him off the base pass to this point in the series. See if he can do it again tonight against the Tigers. Excuse me. Newton County Cougars. Excuse me, sorry about that. The Cougars. Newton County's played some solid competition this year. They have a tough little schedule. Played Madison Central a few times, competitive 0-1 loss against Madison Central. So they can play Northwest Rankin. They had a loss there, but it was 4-5. So they played some big schools. Boswell starts, strike right down center cut. Strike two, swing and a miss. Boswell quickly ahead, 0-2. Little looper over shortstop, 0-2 count. Leadoff hit for Cooper Johnson, center fielder. That'll bring up Vance Richardson, the shortstop. So Boswell ahead 0-2, gives up a two-strike single.
Your next batter is shortstop number 31, Vance Richardson.
Richardson squares the bunt, lays one down to third base, line fielded by Horton. Throw to first and he's safe, beats it out. So the Cougars have the two leadoff runners. On with nobody out here in the top of the first. That'll bring up Cooper Lewis, the right fielder. So two men on, nobody out. Two singles, one looper over shortstop, one bunt down the third baseline, well placed. Or Richardson. Another bunt. Once again, Horton fields it, throws the first, and they record the out. So the Cougars sacrificed their three-hole hitter to get the runners to second and third for their cleanup man, Hayden Amos, catcher for the Cougars. And Coach Smith said he's going to put him on, load the bases, put the double play in order. And we'll go to the five-hole hitter, Collier Mangum. Don't know that Newton saw that coming.
The batter's left fielder number seven, Collier Mangum.
Ball inside from Bosley. Mangum, left fielder, claims he's hit by it. Umpire didn't call it, ran to first. The umpire says he wasn't hit. So Amos, gonna have to take the bat. I believe we got a courtesy runner at first. I believe that's Colt Smith. Ball three, pass ball. Gets through Shirley's legs, right through the wicket. And the Cougars have an early 1-0 lead on a pass ball from Bosworth. Pass ball from Bosworth. So 3-0 count now. To Mangum. There's the strike on the outside half, 3-1. Ball in the dirt. So, an intentional walk and an earned free pass. We'll bring Ethan Burton, the pitcher, to the plate. Good breaking pitch up. Basel can't quite find the strike zone. There's a good fastball from Bosch right at the knees. Count evens up 1-1. Cougars lead 1-0. Scored on a pass ball. Ball inside, 1-2. Boswell will be wise to come right back with that same pitch because that was called off the inside corner. Foul ball out the right-hand side. Count remains 1-2. The umpire called that pitch. He's clearly inside, but if you can get that call all night, you want to try to throw it there. Breaking pitch. Jenkins is going to come home with it. And he's out. Good job. Good job by Shirley to hold his ground and make the tag. Saves a run and two outs. So I had a question as whether Jenkins is going to go home with that ball. Thought maybe should he get it at first. Leeds made the right decision. Cuts the runner down at home. There's a strike at the knees from Boswell. Found the zone now. 0-1. Soft pop up. People's range is under and in center. And so the Knights get out of a jam. And in the first inning, only give up one run in what certainly should have been more for the Cougars. Knights coming to the plate, down 1-0.
to lead off of the night, your shortstop number 25, Jacob Wooten.
So it'll be Wooten, Shirley, and Graham here in the bottom half of the first. Wooten comes in hitting 378, four doubles, three home runs, 13 RBIs from the leadoff spot. Swing out, fouled off, right hand side, count moves to 0-1. Ethan Burton, the pitcher for the Cougars. Ball, breaking pitch up, 1-1. Another fastball up, 2-1. Both starting pitchers in the 80s. Burton's about 81 to 83. Boswell was 85 to 86, 87. Another ball up, 3-1. So Wooten's worth the count to 3-1. I'm sure Coach Smith has him, he has the green light right here, anything in the zone. And that's ball four. And so the Knights get the leadoff runner on here in the bottom of the first. That'll bring Owen Shirley to the plate. Owen Shirley hitting 271. Two doubles, five RBIs. Wooten is a threat to steal at first, got good wheels. There's a bunt that goes behind Shirley. Burton left that ball out there, way behind Owen. I think if I'm Owen, I square again. See if that's gonna give him any problems. And he does, and there's the bunt. Burton fields it cleanly, throws the first, but the Knights have the tying run in scoring position. So Shirley does his job, sets the table for Cannon Graham. Graham's hits 371, seven doubles, three triples, one home run, 19 RBIs. Cannon's a key piece of this of the offense for the Knights. And he swings it well, the Knights score a lot of runs. Ground ball tapped out to the pitcher. And so one pitch, one out. Graham sees one pitch, taps it back to the pitcher, and that'll bring Jaleez Jenkins to the plate. Jenkins hitting 393. Nine doubles, two home runs, 15 RBIs. So now it'll take something in the outfield to get Wooten home. Jacob will be in his two out lead, trying to cut down that turn at third. Ball up, breaking pitch on Burton. Burton's yet to find the strike zone with his breaking ball. Knights would do good to lay off of it until he can throw it for a strike. Another breaking pitch, and there is one for a strike. 1-1 outside half from Burton. Good location. So Jenkins evens, Burton evens the count up, 1-1. Two outs. Cougars lead 1-0. Here in the bottom of the first. Jenkins hits one down the left field line. Left fielder runs over, can't get it. Gonna get up against the wall. Wooten's gonna score. And the Knights have tied it up in the bottom half of the first on a double by Leeds Jenkins. And that'll bring up Carson Smith. Carson sitting 350. Four doubles, 19 RBIs in the season. Smith pops it up on the infield. Shortstop range is over, is under it, and makes the play. So the Cougars get out of it, but the Knights even it up at one apiece. they're 8-9-1, Graham, Talbert, and Johnson. All up from Boswell, 1-0. There's a strike. Right over Kenan Graham's head. Soft line and single, right in the right field. Good location right there from Boswell. You'd like to live there if you're Caden. That is off the inside corner. Hitter wants none of that pitch. Another bunt. Don't let it go foul. And they do. So doing this early in Newton County is telling me they think it's going to be a low scoring game. County's willing to give up outs right here, especially at the bottom of their order, just the top coming up. Probably another reason they're trying to get the guy in scoring position, but they've been quick to go to the bunt already. Ball in the dirt, good block up by Shirley. Count still is 1-2. Nobody out, score's knotted up, 1-1. Here in the top half of the second. Taylor made double play from Wooten, and there it is. You can't make it much easier than that. So two quick outs for Boswell the Knights. That'll flip the order back to the top and Cooper Johnson. Cooper singled his last time up. Ball 0-1-0. Another ball 0-2-0. And quickly 3-0. And strike one, inside half, 3-1. And so he gets the walk anyway. So that's Cooper Johnson. Gets another free pass. It's a free pass. That'll bring Vance Richardson to the plate. Richardson singled his last time up. I believe he got the infield bunt single last time. All low again, 1-0. Caden's got to focus in and find the strike zone. There was a good fastball inside half, 1-1. Good fastball from Caden at the top of the zone. He would like to live right there. Live right there at 86 miles an hour. It's going to make it difficult on the Cougar hitters. And he hits him. I believe the same ball hit the hand, but hand's part of the bat. So if it hits the knob and the hand's on the knob, but it's the knob of the bat and the hand, which is what the umpire said it did, then it's going to be a foul ball. So now 1-2 count. Two outs. Go to first. Nothing doing. Scores tied, one apiece. Ball up. 2-2. Oswald just needs to follow through a little bit more. And so a stolen base. By Johnson. Count runs full, 3-2. Caden's really got to focus here. Doesn't want to walk another hitter with a cleanup hitter on deck. And it gets him looking, strike three. So Caden works out of the runner. Strands the runner at second. And we'll go into the bottom half of the second. Score all knotted up at one apiece. So Hunter Russell will lead off the bottom half of the second. Hunter's hitting 333, three doubles, 15 RBIs, 10 runs scored. Ball outside 1-0. It'll be Russell, Peoples, and Boswell. If anybody reaches Horton. There's just foul. Hunter turned on that breaking pitch inside, just down the left field line foul. Count evens up 1-1. Scores 1-1. All tied up here in the bottom of the second. Tapper back to the mound. Easy play for the pitcher. Flips to first and so one away. That'll bring up Caden Peoples. Peoples the leading hitter for the Knights. Hitting 471. 8 doubles, 11 RBIs. Caden got a little late start this year with the basketball season running long for West Lauderdale deep in the playoffs. Ball outside 1-0. But Caden is caught up quickly. He has not had a home run yet, but he is definitely due for one. Ball outside 2-0. Breaking pitch, swung on a miss, 2-1. Caden Boswell, the pitcher, waits on deck. Another breaking pitch, 2-3-1. See when Caden swung at that first one, he was going to see another one. Foul ball, count moves to 3-2. So now we'll see if Burton has any confidence, how much confidence he's got in his breaking pitch. He got a 3-2 count. You'd like to not give in to Peoples. And there it is. He did throw it. It was out of the zone. Peoples chased it, fouled it off to the right-hand side. Ground ball, foul. Count stays full, 3-2. Peoples battling some good pitches from Burton. And Caden works a walk. So good at bat from Peoples. Peoples has got good speed on the base paths, and that's going to bring Caden Boswell, the pitcher, to the plate. Boswell's hitting 176. One home run, four RBIs in the season. Would not shock me if Peoples takes off. Ball in the dirt, 1-0. Burton's struggling with the zone just a little bit. Strike in the outside corner. Count evens up 1-1. Good breaking pitch from Burton. Ball low, 2-1. Good job by Boz to keep his hands back, stay on that breaking pitch, fouled it off 2-2, just a bit under. But he did a really good job of taking his stride, keeping his hands back, and then reacting to that ball that broke into the zone. Well, if Burton wants to throw him another one of those or not, Caden was right on that. Fastball outside corner, called strike 3. So caught looking is Boswell. That'll bring Carter Horton to the plate. Horton's one double, one triple, five RBIs. Carter had the walk-off hit. Yeah. Bulldogs to end that marathon affair. Ball up, gets past the catcher, and Peoples is going to move into scoring position with two outs. So if Horton can get something into the outfield to fall, I believe Peoples will score easily. He has gotten really, really good. One here in the bottom half of the There's a good breaking pitch from Burton. Evens it up. One ball, one strike, two outs. Cougars have one run on three hits. The Knights one run on one hit. Horton swings and misses. Count goes to 1-2. And swings right through that one, so Burton's out of the inning with no damage. Score remains 1-1. Half of the third.
That half of the inning for the Knights, there were no runs, no hits, no errors, and one man left on base.
The Uptown Cougars, Cooper Lewis, Peyton Amos, Johnny Urbana.
So in the top half of the third, it'll be Lewis, Amos, and Mangum. 3, 4, and 5 for the Cougars. Fastball center cut from Boz. Moves to 0-1. Scores tied 1-1 here in the top of the third. Ball in the dirt. Down he was up 1-1. Up 2-1. Boswell just hasn't got comfortable with the strike zone tonight yet. There's a good fastball. Fisted out to Wooten at shortstop and one out. So now we have Hayden Amos coming to the plate. Amos walked his last time up. Fastball center cut. Best fastball from Boswell yet. 87 miles an hour. Right at the knees. Good location. Ball up. Count evens up 1-1. Scores 1-1. Top of the third. One out. There's another strike inside half. Count moves to 1-2. And strike three. 3-4 pitches. And Amos is having a seat. That'll bring Mangum to the plate. Boswell found him a little rhythm right here. The last two hitters. Collier Mangum coming to the plate. Walked his last time up. Swing and a miss. Counts 0-1. Fouled off. Counts 0-2. Good change up from Boz, a good location, nothing 0-2 pitch. It's a pretty good effort right there to get him to chase something. So now it's 1-2 with two outs, fastball outside half possibly. Now Boz will just let that one get away from him, 2-2, really a wasted pitch right there. Just a little indecisive before he released that one. Ball outside, 3-2. So counts full. Ball four. So Boswell had him way ahead in the count and loses Amos for a free pass at first. Excuse me, Mangum. It'll bring up the pitcher, Ethan Burton. Burton 0-1 on the night. Good fastball inside half. Once again, Boswell out in front, 0-1. Breaking pitch up, 1-1. Didn't quite stay on top of it. Good fastball right there. Counts 1-2. Two count, two outs. Top of the third. Basel with a good breaking pitch. Does it himself, flips to first, and nothing doing for the Cougars. They strand one at the top of the third inning, going into the bottom half. Score still 1-1. So the Knights come back to the top of their order. Jacob Wooten will lead off. Wooten's 0-0, walked with a run scored. Ball low, 1-0. Looked like a change up from Burton. Fouled off the right hand side. Count evens up 1-1. There's the line drive, but it's going to be right at the left fielder. Almost misplayed it out there, but just speared it at the last second. Wooten hammered that one, but just right to the left field. Tough break for Jacob. Hit it really hard. Owen Shirley will come to the plate.
Owen Shirley.
Ball, 1-0. Scores 1-1 still. Bottom of the third. Ball up, 2-0. Have one run on three hits. The Knights have one run on one hit. Ball low, 3-1. Knights just haven't swung the bats well the last two or three games. Just really haven't put a big offensive onslaught together at any time. Good play by the shortstop and a hard hit ground ball to short. But first two hitters for the Knights are gone here in the bottom half of the third. Two hard hit balls, right to Cougar defenders. That'll bring Cannon Graham to the plate. Graham lined out his last time up. There's a line drive single from Graham out to the right fielder, and Graham's on base with two outs. That'll bring Jenkins to the plate. Jenkins With the Knights' other hit tonight, he's 1-for-1, an RBI, drove in the Knights' only run his last time up. So if you're Coach Smith, you might try to get do something to try and get Graham in the scoring position at second. Swing fouled off from Jenkins and a changeup. One thing's for sure, if Graham does go, the second baseman's covering the bag. The shortstop's not anywhere near double play depth. They're shading for Jenkins to pull. Anything poked out towards right field is going to get through without a doubt. And with two outs, Graham should be running the crack of the bat. There's a fly ball out to left field. Left fielder coming in, and he makes the play. So a pop out from Jenkins ends the inning. Knights get nothing on one hit from Graham. Score remains 1-1 in the top of the fourth. The duo for the Cougars would be Toms, Graham, and Talbert. Scores 1-1. Top half of the fourth.
Filling out for the Cougars in second place number 5, Gavin Toms.
Ball up, 1-0. Strike on the outside half, evens it up 1-1. Fastball on the outside half, 1-2. 7, 8, and 9 for the Cougar order. Ball low, evens it up 2-2. Ball high, 3-2. Cajun's had a lot of three ball counts tonight. There's a good breaking pitch. Shirley gets it. Comes to the inside, throws to first. So the first out of the inning. The top of the fourth recorded via the strikeout. Dalton Graham coming to the plate. Graham's 1-for-1. Singled his last time up. Breaking pitch up and out of the zone, 1-0. Oswald seems to be pointing to the rubber like something's bothering him. 2-0. Long look thanks over there to the coach and staff. Now 3-0. Something, Boswell's not comfortable with something. Don't know what it is. Coach Smith's going to have a word with the umpire. I don't know if Boz is saying something's wrong with the rubber, pitching rubber. And so now we're going to call time, go check it out. Boswell's come off the field, not sure what's going on. He's gone into the dugout. He pointed to his foot. Thought maybe he was pointing to the pitching rubber. Maybe he's got something wrong with his foot. Dugout, it's come back out. So I don't know if he got some medical treatment, maybe needed something wrapped, but he definitely pointed down towards the rubber, which I thought he was talking about, but evidently may have been his foot. And the athletic trainer's in the West Lauderdale dugout, so maybe he got some kind of treatment or something that's causing him some issues. So back to a 3-0 count, nobody on. Well, whatever it was worked for that pitch. Now it's 3-1. So 3-1, one out. Score tied at one apiece here on top of the fourth. And that's ball four. So that'll be the fifth walk that Newton County has received tonight. That's going to bring up Landry Tolbert. Throw to first. Inside fastball, strike one. Boswell took a little bit off of that one to get it over, get ahead 0-1. Knights would love a ground ball. A shorter second. Pitch out, throw behind him. Good throw, probably gets him. Ball's just foul side of first base. Strike, center cut. Count goes to 1-2. Ground ball up the middle. Wooten does a great job, throws it to first and gets it out. Looked at second, thought about it. Would have been a tough flip to Cannon Graham. Jacob does the smart thing and gets that out at first base. So Cooper Johnson, that flips the order back to the top. Cooper Johnson hits with the runner on second. Two outs. Cooper's one for one with a run scored and a walk. Ball outside, 2-0. Fastball and a changeup. Moves the count to 2-0 from Caden. There's a center cut fastball. Goes to 2-1. Ball in the dirt. Good job by Sherman. Owen's been an excellent defensive catcher this year. He has been rock solid behind the plate. You don't want to jinx him, but he has done an exceptional job behind the plate this year. Fastball center, 3-2. Count moves full, so 3-2, two outs. Score tied, one apiece. And he walks him. So another walk. And that's six walks on the night through three innings. Fastball and walks come back to haunt you. They really do. He holds them up, which I don't understand. Should have been off and going with two outs. No reason he shouldn't have scored on that center to single to center. Cooper Lewis coming to the plate. Cooper Lewis 0 for 1. Bases juice for the Cougars. Check his swing. Umpire's going to say he went. 0-1, and I believe the umpire's correct right there. Now quickly 0-2. So Boswell's out in front 0-2. For the three-hole hitter, Lewis. Tom Boswell, bury a breaking ball in the outside corner and low. Change up, not a bad idea. Count goes to 1-2. A little bit higher, maybe a little bit more competitive, and Lewis probably has to swing at that. It's too far out of the zone to make him think about it. Ground ball. Easy toss to first, and a nice get out of it. So the Cougars strand the bases loaded. They get no runs on one hit. Nice coming to the plate in the bottom of the fourth. Score still 1-1. Carson Smith coming to the plate. It'll be Smith, Russell, and Peoples. Smith 0 for 1. Ball in the dirt. 1 and 0.
Carson Smith.
Smith swings and misses way out in front of an off-speed pitch. 1 and 1. Really good off-speed pitch right there from Burton. Fouled off the right-hand side. Count 1 and 2. Carson fouled straight back. Count remains still 1 and 2. Ball outside 2 and 2. So Burton's at 48 pitches. He's been pretty efficient in his three innings to this point. Knights need to really try to get his pinch count up. Try to get some guys on base, put some pressure on Newton County. Strike three. Knights offense has just not been able to get off the snide here in the last three or four games. We just need something good to happen. So Smith strikes out. It's the first out of the inning. Hunter Russell comes to the plate. Ball outside, 1-0. Russell fouls it off the right-hand side. Ball's drifting into the visitor bullpen. First baseman kind of lost his footing over there in the wet grass. I'm sure the dew's got it a little slippery. Kind of slipped and couldn't regain his balance in time to make the plays. The ball falls in foul territories. Hunter has a 1-1 count with one out. Score 1-1 here in the bottom of the fourth. At this point in the game, the Cougars have one run on four hits. Knights one run on two hits. Knights have gotten two walks given to them. The Cougars have gotten six walks given to them. Ball outside, 2-1. Fouled off, count evens up 2-2. And that's off the handle, out in front, easy play for the pitcher. And so the Knights have two quick outs here in the bottom half of the fourth. Caden Peoples coming to the plate. The Peoples 0 for 0, walked his last time up. Ball outside, 1 and 0. Ball in. Curve on the dirt, 2 and 0. Burton's probably a wise decision. This is the one guy that could give West Lauderdale the lead with one swing of the bat for sure. It's a line drive. Ground ball goes right through the wicket of the second baseman. Second baseman never touched it. Toms pulled up on it a little bit quick, went right through his legs, and Peoples is on via the air. And that'll bring Caden Bosel to the plate with a chance to help himself. Bosel struck out his last time up. See if Coach Smith will put Peoples in motion here, try to get him in scoring position. First pitch, strike 0-1. Peoples is going to go. It's going to be right here. There he is. Peoples advances on the pass ball. Count 1-1. Score 1-1. Bottom of the fourth. All up, breaking pitch. High and inside. Count moves to 2-1. It's going to take a hit to score, Peoples. I'm sure Coach Smith's going to roll Caden. Anything just be within the outfield. Strike two. Caden retreated to second. Do not know why. Just that was a little bit of an inside move and then pitch by Burton. Burton, I wasn't watching that. Could have been the case. So now it's 2-2. Boswell fouls it off. Out of play. It's 2 balls, 2 strikes, 2 outs. Knights have the lead run, standing at second. It's going to take a hit to get him home. Catcher sets up outside. Boswell with a bogus throw to the third baseman's legs. Right under his glove. Burton hung a curveball in the center of the plate. Boswell hit a solid ground ball to the third baseman who didn't stay down on it. The Knights have a 2-1 lead. Cooper Rayner will run for the pitcher Boswell. So Boswell helps himself out, gets some solid contact. Talbert at third, didn't stay down, and the Knights have captured the lead here in the bottom half of the fourth. Ball up, 1-0. So the Knights starting to get into Burton's pitch count a little bit. Burton's now at 65 pitches. Ball thrown in the right. In the right field, I believe Rayner's speed is going to get to third easily. Here comes the throw. The throw comes through to third. And Cooper's there easy. That was an unnecessary throw from right field to third. I don't believe Cooper would have gone anywhere. A lot of risk taken right there by the Cougars. But now, multiple ways Rayner can get home from third base here with 2 outs. So Carter Horton at the plate. Strikeout victim his last time up. But now he can score pass ball, error, hit, ball, many ways to get the runner home here with 2 outs. Horton swings and misses an outside fastball. Count moves to 0-1. Knights lead 2-1 now. Knights have 2 runs on 2 hits. Cougars 1 run on 4 hits. Cougars playing Horton straight away. Carter swings right through that one, 1-2. Ezra sets up outside. Ball low. Down evens up 2-2. After Horton, you go back to the top of the order. Catcher sets up outside again. And Horton swings through it. So the Cougars get out of there with only one run damage. Knights will take a 2-1 lead in the top of the fifth. So it'll be Amos, Mangum, and Burton for the Cougars in the top of the fifth inning. Amos is 0-for-1, strikeout victim, and earned a base on balls. Say foul ball off the chute. It'll be an 0-1 to Amos. Ball just below the knees, 1-1. Another ball, 2-1. Bowser's not happy with the zone, but that is a low strike below his knees. Graham with an easy Sunday hopper, flip to first. And so Bowser retires Amos via the ground out to Graham. That'll bring Collier Mangum to the plate. Mangum's 0-for-2 with two walks. Fastball just off the plate outside, 1-0. Scores 2-1 Knights. Knights have two runs on two hits. Swing and a miss for Mangum. Count evens up 1-1. Cougars have one run on four hits, Knights two runs, two hits. Swing and a miss, Mangum again. 1-2 count, and Amos does not look comfortable at the plate right now. If I'm Caden, they go right back with what he just did. He fouled it off. Maybe a little bit higher up in the zone. Something off the plate, outside, about letter high. A little dinker, Jen Jenkins makes the play on a looper off the handle of Amos. So two quick outs here in the top of the fifth, and this is the kind of inning Caden needs. Caden needs to close this out quick. Pitch count's growing. If he wants to get through another inning, I believe he's going to have a quick out right here. So counts 0-1. Two outs, scores 2-1 Knights.
Hands up! Pitcher Ethan Burton at the plate, fouls it off, and out of play. That's a good-looking pitch. That's one Boswell probably has reason to be upset about. Good breaking pitch, broke off the outside half. Swing fouled it off, 1-2. Burton's choked way up on the handle. Ball 2-2. Ball up 3-2. So Boswell's letting the strike call, balls and strike calls get to him a little bit here on this hitter. Just needs to focus and pitch. There it is. Good 3-2 breaking pitch. Throw to first. And Cougars go 1-2-3. In the top half of the fifth. Coming to the bottom. Nice lead 2-1. So the Knights go to the top of the order. Jacob Wooten, 0-for-1, run scored in a walk. Ball way outside, 1-0. Bottom of the fifth, Knights lead 2-1. Knights have 2 runs on 2 hits. And Jacob pops it up, short right field. Right fielder coming in and successfully makes the play. So Jacob retired on 2 pitches for the first out. Bottom of the fifth inning, Owen Shirley will come to the plate. Shirley 0-for-1. Knights only have 2 hits tonight.
There's one out, the batter's catcher number 13, Owen Shirley.
Good pitch from Burton. The breaking pitch, center cut. Count goes to 0-1. Outside fastball, down, 1-1. Way outside, 2-1. Thank you. 3-1. So Shirley ahead 3-1. Heights would like to get a base runner and give Graham and Jenkins a shot to bring them around. And there it is. Burton lost a little bit of command in this inning. Shirley will take the free pass down the first. Tag out Cooper Rayner up. No, not going to be Cooper Rayner this time. It's going to be Dixon, courtesy runner Dixon for the Knights.
Pitch run for the catcher, number 16, Braden Dixon.
Braden Dixon.
Second baseman, number 5, Cannon.
Cannon Graham at the plate. Cannon's got good hands. You wonder, Coach Smith is thinking about a hit and run, something like that. Putting speed on it first. Man's not going to swing and miss very often. Breaking pitch. Ground fouls off the left-hand side. Counts 0-1 with one out. Knights lead 2-1 here in the bottom of the fifth inning. Ball up. Count evens up 1-1. Ball in the dirt, 2-1. And just a little bit ahead of that, foul it off. Count evens up 2-2. Big gap in right center, left center. Center fielder shaded to Cannon to pull. Right fielder guarding the line. Ground ball, hit to the first baseman, throws back. So Graham grounds out, but that'll get Dixon into scoring position. So he advances the runner, two outs. Jenkins at the plate, Dixon should score on a hit.
Two outs, first baseman number
3, Lee Jenkins. Jenkins calls for receiving time. Pitcher leads away. Right there, catcher leads. He's got a peek and eye at the catcher, maybe just sneak a peek to see where he's setting up at. Now he's coming back inside. Ball called strike. Umpire's defense, he's called that a strike all night both ways. And look where he sets up. It's right behind the catcher over his left shoulder. And going to be a naturally called strike from that position. There's another strike on the outside half. So Jenkins down 1-2. Fastball in the inside corner. Breaking pitch in the outside corner. 1-2 count. Ball up and away. 2-2. Not a bad pitch by Burton. Maybe a little waste pitch. See if he would chase something. Now look for him to come back in the zone. Leeds has got to be ready right here. Catcher sets up on the outside half. Ball inside, called strike 3. went to the inside part of the plate, with the catcher set up on the outside, and Jenkins gets caught looking. And so the Knights will carry a 2-1 lead in the top of the sixth. So we have Tom's Graham and Talbert coming up for the Cougars. Ball up, 1-0. Looks like the Knights have inserted Braden Warren into the game. Tough play from Jacob. Going to tell a good arm, and he's safe. That's one you got to choose to come get and get rid of it. Once it's such a high hop, you really got to go get it on the high hop or the short hop. So the Cougars have had the tying run on, nobody out. And that'll bring Graham to the plate. Coach is calling signals, not usually called. Look at all the time that's going on between the hitter, the runner, and the coach. I don't know what that call was. Looked like he pulled back. I think it's going to be 1-0. They asked for an appeal, but it doesn't look like anybody's going to ask for it. So 1-0 count. Now 2-0. The Basel's got to forget about that first pitch. Let's concentrate on throwing strikes. The last thing he wants to do is walk the winning run, his tying run in the scoring position. There's a good one. Basel makes the play. So there we go, one out. Take the out they're going to give you, then deal with the next hitter. So now you got Talbert coming into play. Talbert's 0 for 2. And then Johnson, the leadoff hitter, on deck. Cougars have out hit the Knights 5-2, but are losing on the scoreboard 2-1. The line drive, gonna double him up off a second. Good throw, gets him, had all day to get it there. So, tough break for the Knights, seemingly out of the inning. And the Cougars get lucky and get a man back on second. Now two outs, and reset. However, that does flip the order to the Cougars' leadoff hitter. And he is one that could get you. Luca comes over, goes to first, and he gets him. So Boswell gets out of the inning. The Knights salvage the 2-1 lead. And we go to the bottom of the sixth with the Knights leading 2-1.
Carson Smith, Hunter Russell, and Caden People.
Carson Smith, 0 for 2 on the night. Got to give Burton credit. He's kept the Knights off balance. Only giving up 2 runs on 2 hits. It has been enough for the Knights to have a 2-1 lead here in the bottom of the 6th. Smith fouls one off the left-hand side. Going to get in the Knights bullpen. Knights have some action down there as I believe Caden Boswell is getting close to reaching his maximum pitch count. So 0-1 to Carson. Breaking pitch. Smith fouls off. Counts 0-2. There's a good swing by Smith. It's going to take a strong throw to get him. And he's safe. Carson runs pretty well. He's able to beat out the infield single. So the Knights will have their third hit of the game. That'll bring Hunter Russell to the plate. Be interesting to see what Coach Smith already.
The next batter is left fielder number 1, Hunter Russell.
So Cooper Rayner is going to take first.
Cooper Rayner.
And now Hunter Russell. They're going to bring the third baseman in if you're the Cougars. Looking for a bunt from the Knights. And that is probably exactly what they're going to get. Right here, Hunter Russell's job is to bunt this ball up the first base line if that's what the Knights have called. And he busts it straight to the third baseman. They'll take that out at first. Nobody's covering third. Here comes the throw. It's in the right lane of left field. The Cougars have thrown it away. And the Knights have manufactured a run. It's amazing what happens when you make kids throw the ball. Put something on the ground, make them make a play. Next thing you know, good things happen. The Knights pick up an insurance run and run the score to 3-1. The out was recorded at first. Wild throw to third. Caden Peoples coming to the plate. Peoples 0 for 1 with a run scored to base on balls tonight. Ball outside, breaking pitch, low and away. Peoples with a ball right between the legs of the third baseman. Peoples is going to round and try for 2. Union County's going to throw it. Going to throw it in the right field. And Peoples is going to get all the way to third. And now don't be shocked if the Knights squeeze him home. And I say that because if West does end up winning this game, they still got to go to Newton County. And the tiebreaker, should Newton County win at Newton County, would be run differential. So you look for the Knights here to do anything they can to get this run home from third. Newton County has committed four errors, two in this inning, which have been really, really costly. Cougars are going to go to the pen. Dalton Graham's going to come in pitch for Newton County. Looks like Colt Smith has entered the game at third base. So the fourth run of the game for the Knights stands 90 feet away in the form of Caden Peoples. Caden Boswell will come to the plate trying to help his own calls. One out, Knights now lead 3-1.
With one out, that is the pitcher number 21, Caden
Boswell. Infield is in. Any hard hit ground ball, not right to somebody. More importantly, they're giving Peoples all the lead he wants at third base, right at the knees on a sweeping breaking pitch from Graham. Nobody's holding Peoples on if he wants to get any kind of lead he wants on that third baseline right now. There it comes. There it is. He'll not stop it. No way to stop that if you're not going to hold him on third. And so now the score moves to 4-1, which is important. Should the Knights be able to close this out with a three-run lead, then Cougars will have to beat the Knights by four come Friday night to win the district crown. It's a good job by Boswell. He got the job done, got the run home.
The batter's number 30, Dalen Marshall.
So now Dalen Marshall coming to the plate. Daylon Marshall pinch hitting for Carter Horton. All 0-1-0. Graham doesn't think so. Ball is most certainly low. Line drive. Good play by the first baseman. Ball hit hard. But the Knights put two on the board and take a 4-1 lead into the top half of the seventh. Knights do have action in the bullpen. Basel returns for his, what should be his final inning of work. Newton County. We have Richardson, Lewis, and Amos coming to the plate. Ball outside. Richardson's 2-for-3. Fastball, get out to center. People's got good speed. Corrals that one easily out in right center field. So two pitches, one out. Cade wants to make it through this full game. That's exactly how he needs to get started. So now you have Lewis. Lewis 0-for-2.
One out, batter for right fielder number 16, Cooper Lewis.
Ground ball. Graham fields it cleanly. Now. Two quick outs for the Cougars. Couldn't have drawn it up any better if you're Caden. So now you got Amos at the plate. Amos 0-for-2. There's a looper. Jacob wins it, and that's the ball game. The Knights will take a 4-1 victory and lead the division by a game and three runs over the Newton County Cougars. Next game will be Friday night, I believe, in Newton County at 7 o'clock. Winning pitcher, of course, will be Caden Basel. Basel went 7 complete, gave up 5 hits, weren't unrun. Walked 6, struck out 4. Offensively, the Knights only managed 3 hits, but man, were they effective. Graham went 1-for-3. Jenkins went 1-for-3. Carson Smith 1-for-3. But most importantly, the Knights put a lot of pressure on the Cougar defense, and the Cougar defense just couldn't make the plays tonight to secure the victory, and the Knights were able to take it home with a 4-1 win. So, Newton County game Friday night at 7 p.m. at their place. You can make it out there, go watch it. It'll be for the district championship. I believe the Cougars are going to have to beat the Knights by 4, but I could be wrong about that. I believe it'll go to run differential if they split the series. But right now, the Knights hold the lead. 7-0 in district. Newton County drops to 6-1 in district. So, if you want to see some good baseball and competitive, two competitive teams going at it, make the trip to Newton County Friday night at 7 p.m. This is Marcus Willis for West Lauderdale Baseball and West Lauderdale Athletics. We will see you this Saturday for the next home broadcast I believe that game is at 3 o'clock. So the Knights will be here hosting. Madison Central, yeah, at 3 o'clock this Saturday will be the next home broadcast. After that, the playoffs start. Got a week between then and the playoffs, but yeah, Madison Central will be a tall task. Good team coming in here, Jerry Boatner Field. So if you can make it out to the ballpark on Saturday at 3 p.m., there'll be a JV game at 1. Come watch the Knights and Madison Central get after it this Saturday. So for Westall Athletics, Westall Baseball, this is Marcus Willis signing off.